Hello dear students, hope you all are doing good. I am Kirishna Mulipuri from Nitya College of Pharmaceutical Sciences, Bangalore. Would like to take a topic on the structure and uses of alcohol, which is under Pharmaceutical Organic Chemistry under Unit 3. Okay, so various structures and uses of different alcohols will be discussed in this session. So the first compound is ethyl alcohol. So it is commonly called as ethanol. We will see in our lab as a solvent or to make some synthetic work. So the structure of ethyl alcohol is, you can see here, whenever you say "eth", the prefix "eth" says that the compound contains two carbon, and "ol", the suffix "ol" indicates that the compound contains a hydroxyl group. Okay, so two carbon with one hydroxyl group. That's all. Remaining all carbons should be satisfied with valency by giving hydrogen here. So you can see here the first group is methyl group and the second group is methylene group. It's not methyl, it is methylene. Methylene, because one hydrogen is left from methyl and then hydroxyl group. So collectively it is called ethyl alcohol or ethanol. When you see the molecular formula, CH3CH2OH, or empirical formula C2H3O. Okay, coming to the uses. So in this session we would be learning the structures and uses of all these alcohols. Okay, so coming to the uses of ethyl alcohol, as I told you, it is a very common solvent in the especially in the chemistry labs. Okay, so apart from our chemistry lab synthetic work, it is also having use medicinally as antiseptic. If you go for any hospital, if they wanted to give any injection, first they will rub this alcohol, right? It is used as antiseptic. The main category is antiseptic and then disinfectant. Okay, so mainly like to maintain the sterile environment, this will be used for removing all the bacteria. Then chemical solvent, as I have told already, chemical solvent. Then synthesis of other organic compounds. So one is used as solvent in the chemistry labs, and the second one is to synthesize various molecules. Like different kind of synthetic molecules can be synthesized using this solvent, and also used as an alternative fuel source. So when there is a deficiency or lacuna in the fuel levels, we may use this as one of the best source. So these are the different uses of ethyl alcohol, commonly called as ethanol. You all can pan down all these points with the structure. Okay. The next compound is methyl alcohol. It is commonly called as wood alcohol. Why? Because in the earlier days, this methyl alcohol is prepared or distilled from wood material. That is why it is called wood alcohol. Nowadays they are distilling from the carbon sources, but previously it was taken or extracted or distilled from wood. That is why it is also called as wood alcohol. You can see the structure here. Whenever you say methyl or meth, the prefix meth indicates it contains one carbon, and alcohol means it contains a functional group, that is OH. Okay, so the remaining three will be filled with the hydrogen. It is also called as methanol, and other name is wood alcohol because of its source. Okay, coming to the uses, it is the best feedstock to produce various chemicals like acetic acid and formaldehyde. Okay, so it is also used to synthesize various molecules and solvents for recrystallization. It is very best solvent to extract or to isolate the pure crystals, especially polar compounds. We will use this methanol, and also a best reagent in the laboratory. Even we will use this solvent for chromatography, like separation of various compounds. We will use chromatographic technique where methanol is one of the mobile phase or one of the solvents used. And the next compound is chlorobutanol. Okay, here the chloro indicates it contains chlorine, and then bute prefix indicates it contains four carbons with suffix ol. Ol means it contains hydroxy group. So all these alcohols, IUPAC name, if you observe, the suffix will be ending with ol. That means it contains an OH group or hydroxyl group. Okay? So this is the structure of chlorobutanol. But means 4 carbon. You can see here in the two bridges, 2 carbons are there, and here dimethyl bridges are there. So collectively 4 carbons are present in this compound. Coming to the uses, it is a best antibacterial agent and fungicidal. So it's not fungistatic, it is fungicidal, means it is almost killing all the fungi. And then a concentration of 0.5%, it is used as preservative, means to increase the shelf life or preservation, so it is used as preservative in injection, eye drops and mouthwashes. The you can see eye drops and injections are will be having a shorter period of shelf life or pHof value. So to increase the storable capacity of these formulations, we will use this chlorobutanol as a preservative at a concentration of 0.5%. And the next use is sedative and hypnotic. So depending on the dose level, it is used as sedative, and in higher doses it is used as hypnotic drug. Okay, so these are different uses of chlorobutanol. And the next compound is phytosteryl alcohol. So this phytosteryl alcohol, it is also called as phytylsteryl alcohol. So it is a combination of phytyl alcohol and steryl alcohol. So phytyl alcohol means it contains 16 carbons, whereas steryl alcohol means it contains 18 carbons. So collectively, phytylsteryl alcohol contains 16 and 18 carbons. You can see the two longer chains here. One contains 16 and the other contains 18 carbons. So together these two molecules join together and form this phytosteryl alcohol. It is nothing but a fatty alcohol. So you can see here the white granules. So this compound is existing as white granules. This is mainly used as emulsifying agent. Okay, even emollient, different uses are there. Let's discuss the uses. Okay, the first one is emulsion stabilizer. So the basic problem of emulsions is sometimes stability problem. So to increase the stability, generally in the formulations they will use this phytylsteryl alcohol. The next use is opacifying agent. Okay, then foam boosting surfactant. So since it contains longer carbons with the hydroxyl group, definitely it will have the surfactant property. So to increase the foam, it will be used. And in the aqueous and non-aqueous, viscosity increasing agent. So what is the main purpose of this? To increase the viscosity. Okay, so thickness or the viscosity will be increased by using this agent, and also it has emollient property. So it gives a very smooth feel to the skin. So it will be used both in water in oil and oil in water emulsions, and even in the anhydrous formulations also this agent will be used. And it is commonly used in hair conditioners and other hair products because it contains the soft appeal to the skin or to the hair care. That is why it is used both in the skin care and hair care products. And the next compound is benzyl alcohol. If you see the structure, benzyl group, we know benzene with one carbon and attached with one hydroxyl group. It is called benzyl alcohol. Okay? So the uses of benzyl alcohol, the main use is bacteriostatic agent and also preservative at lower concentrations in intravenous medications, cosmetics and topical drugs. Okay, the next compound is glycerol. It is very famous compound in our labs. Almost pharmaceutics and pharmaceutical chemistry labs, we will be using this glycerol. So if you see the structure of this glycerol, it's a trihydroxyl alcohol, means three hydroxyl groups are attached and three carbons are present. Okay, so this is also called as glycerin or glycerol. And coming to the uses of glycerol, it is used as main uses is solvent and also sweetening agent and also a preservative and humectant at low C, and also it is used as a chilling agent. Okay, it's like excipient kind, mainly in the food or beverages also it will be used. and also thickening agent in the liquors, and combination of water and glycerin are used to preserve certain types of plant seeds. Okay, like even some specimens also will be stored by using different organic solvents like formaldehyde, glycerol, and etc. Okay, the next compound is propylene glycol, shortly called as PG. In the cutic lab, we will be using it mainly as a carrier. Okay, so this is the structure of propylene glycol. As the prefix is starting with pro, it contains three carbon and it's a dihydric alcohol. And use it. So mainly, it is also a feedstock for the production of unsaturated polyester resin. It is used in various edible items, means food items like coffee-based drinks, liquid sweetening agent, ice cream, liquid dairy products, and soda. The solvent in many pharmaceuticals. So it is a best solvent in many pharmaceutical formulations, including oral, injectables, and topical formulations. Okay. Suppose some drugs are insoluble in water, then they will make use of this PG or propylene glycol as a solvent and a carrier. So these are the different uses of propylene glycol. And the other use, which we do not know, is artificial tears. So in making of artificial tears, they will use propylene glycol as the main ingredient. Okay, so dear students, I have taken all the compounds. Please write down the structure and use it. If you have any doubts, you can comment in the comment section. Okay, good luck to all of you. Thank you.